anything with driving
Dear students, we shall go to the lecture 2 of module 5 today now. Now, we have already discussed in the previous class the Francis turbine, its description, working proportion and design. And this class will be dealing with the numerical problems. Immediately, we shall go into recapitulation of the previous class for a small time. Then we can easily do the problem now. So here this is a turbine, this is the reaction turbine, and this is the draft tube, and this is the penstock now. So here, first of all, we have to know what is the energy that is being consumed by the turbine. Means you have to take what is the energy that is supplied here, that is at the exit of the turbine and at the exit of the draft tube. So these two points have been taken into account. Then we have written the Bernoulli's equation, that is the total energy available at the exit of the penstock to total energy available at the draft tube, that we will take it now. So this is the Bernoulli's equation we have written, and we have taken the datum at the tail race exit, and we have assumed the velocity in the draft tube as Vd squared by 2g. Then the equation what we have written will be modified to this pattern now. So if we neglect the velocity in the draft tube, velocity energy in the draft tube, the equation for the head in the turbine will be coming to this equation now. Now this is the runner of a Pelton wheel turbine. So here we have drawn the velocity triangle for both inlet and outlet now. So this is the radius of the outlet and this is the radius of the inlet. R1 is the radius of inlet, R2 is the radius of outlet, or it is D2 is the diameter of the outlet and D1 is the diameter of the inlet. The flow is in this direction. This is being called as the absolute velocity. The angle between the absolute velocity and the direction of velocity, runner velocity, will tell you the angle alpha. The same thing is true here now. The angle between the absolute velocity at the exit and the direction of the runner velocity at the exit will give you the beta now. And the theta is the angle between the relative velocity and the direction of the runner velocity, the runner velocity vector, that is theta. Similarly, phi will come into picture, where Vr2 is called as the relative velocity at the exit now. V1 and V2 are called as the absolute velocities. Vr1 and Vr2 are called as the relative velocities now. Alpha and beta are the angles subtended between the absolute velocity and the direction of the runner velocity, runner velocity vector at exit, at entrance and at exit, alpha and beta now. Theta and phi are called as the angle subtended between the relative velocities and the runner velocity vector at the entrance and exit now. Vw1, it is called as the velocity of wheel. Vw1 is called as the velocity of wheel, which is responsible for the rotation now. So Vw1 and Vw2 are the horizontal component of absolute velocities. That is velocity of the wheel at the entrance and exit now. The same Vw2 will come here now, Vw1 will come at the entrance now. Similarly, Vf1 and Vf2 are called as velocity of flow. So what is velocity of flow? Velocity of flow is called as the vertical component of absolute velocity. So that means the vertical component of this one is Vf1. The vertical component of this one is Vf2 now. Okay. So this is being discussed, and if the angle is radial, then it will be a triangle now. It will be a triangle with phi now at exit. At exit. So this will be a triangle with 90 degree. The angle will become 90 if it is beta is equal to beta is radial. Beta is radial. That you should know it now. Okay. So radial means the beta will be always 90 degree. If beta is acute and beta is obtuse, the triangle, now in this case the beta is acute, beta is obtuse means you may have the triangle in this pattern. 1 minute. It may be in this pattern. This will be beta will be obtuse. So this may be the condition of the triangle. So more about it, you will be knowing it now. This is VR2 and V2. So we will be knowing about it. So this is what we have drawn now. Beta is acute. Now you can see here now, beta is acute. So if beta becomes obtuse here now, the triangle will become like this now. The triangle will become in this pattern, and this will be the angle of theta now. This will become the angle of beta now, and Vf2 will be there now. So this will shift to this point now. Okay, so we will be, when we solve the problem, we will be knowing how the triangle will be drawn for it now. So at that time U2 will be greater than U2 will be greater. U2 will be this much now. If beta becomes this one, that will become U2 now. So let us look into it afterwards now. So now the work done is being calculated as usual. It is nothing but it is Fx into U is called as the work done. What is Fx? Fx is equal to mass into change in velocity, V2 minus of V1. So that is in the x direction. If it is, it will become m is equal to rho av into vw1 minus of vw2. If you want to find the work done, fx into u is to be taken, corresponding u1 and u2 will come into picture now. That's what we have written here now. That is the work done now. So what is work done? Work done is equal to force into velocity or displacement, the same thing what we are saying, velocity per second. That is the discussion, that is what we have discussed in earlier classes also now. So rho is nothing but here W by G, AV is nothing but Q, rho is nothing but W by G, and Q is nothing but A into V, that is being substituted here now, in this case now. Q is equal to AV is being substituted here now. So this is the expression that you will get it now. So if at all, if as I told you, if the value of VW2 becomes zero, that means if the flow is radial, if the flow becomes radial, then VW2 will become zero. When VW2 becomes zero, we will be having maximum maximum velocity, maximum efficiency. So the equation is being written in the last line. That is the work done when you are having the VW2 is equal to, when VW2 is equal to zero. That's what we are written here now. So that means the flow is radial, means it is 90 degree. That's what we say now. Now the eta H, that is the hydraulic efficiency. What is hydraulic efficiency? Hydraulic efficiency is being defined as shaft power, how much of water, how much of energy that is being given for the shaft, divided by the water power. What is water power? Water power, what is we are supplying? What is the power we are supplying from the penstock to the turbine? That is equal to WQH now. Shaft power is nothing but what? It is nothing but the work done. So this is nothing but WQ by G into VW1 plus U1. So however, if you don't have the radial output, then VW2 U2 will also come into picture. So that is the shaft power. If at all, if there is some bearing loss, then mechanical losses is also to be taken. Then shaft power divided by the power developed by the runner will take into account the friction loss, or it is the bearing loss between the runner and shaft. So that is the difference that will take into care of the eta M. That is the, what is the actual output at the shaft, which will be transferred. This will be transferred to the generator. This will be transferred to the generator. This energy will be transferred to generator. This is shaft power. But what is developed at the runner exit is this much now. So what is the difference? The difference is friction loss and the bearing loss. That will take care of by means of the mechanical efficiency. Overall efficiency is being given as eta H into eta M. That we know it, which is equal to 80 to 90% now. So the working proportion for which we have discussed, N is equal to B1 by D1 now. What is B1? What is D1? We have already told. It is nothing but the width to the diameter at the inlet. Width to the diameter at the inlet will give you N, the value of N. That will be ranging from 0.10 to 0.45. The flow ratio is being defined as usual. We have defined it as Vf is equal to Kf into root 2gh. The same equation what we have used in the other turbines is being utilized, where H is called as the H net is to be utilized here now. So that is about Kf will be about 0.15 to 0.30 now. The speed ratio, it discusses about the speed of the turbine. So the speed of the runner, that will be given by Ku is equal to U is equal to Ku into root 2gh. It can also be obtained U is equal to pi d n by 60. Using this expression you can obtain, or using this you can express. Here h is nothing but once again the h net, where Ku is called as the speed ratio, where Ku is called as the speed ratio, which can be defined from this. This is called as the speed ratio. Using this expression, we will find this one now. So while we are designing the Francis turbine, we have to take care of how much of power we want to develop, what is the speed of the turbine, and what is the head developable. Then only we have to go for the design of the turbine now. So before designing the turbine, we have to assume eta naught, eta H, N, Kf and Ku. And the value of eta naught, as you know, eta naught is equal to P divided by WQH. What is P here now? P is nothing but the shaft power. P is nothing but the shaft power. Shaft power divided by the water power. Water power now. So using this, we have obtained eta naught into WQH is equal to P. That is the power I want to develop now. So the value of B1, D1, T1 can be obtained knowing this D1 and P1 at the entrance. At the entrance, it will be equal to, if there are some loss because of the number of vanes that we are providing, generally it is equal to 16 to 24 will be the number of vanes that we will provide. Generally, there will be a loss about 8 to 10% of loss because of the thickness that will be. Thickness, that area is being get lost now. The area is being get lost. That is being taken as pi d into b. What is pi d? Pi d the circumference. Pi d this circumference into b. Into b nothing but what? The thickness. This is the width now. This is the width in the at the entrance. This will be the width, at the exit also it will be the width now. Whereas the width will be going on reducing as you go to the D2 now. So pi D1 into B1 is the developed, if you develop this one completely, that means if you fold it to enlarge this, pi D will be the circumference into B, that is the total area over which the water is going, minus of the loss due to the thickness of the vanes. So if Z is the number of vanes that we are providing or the number of buckets we are providing, and these runners are having the thickness is so much loss is there, so that will give you the actual area now. So actual area is equal to pi d1 b1 into kt1. This kt1 take care of the thickness loss, or any other losses that is going to take place. Generally it is thickness, so that is called as the thickness coefficient. Also generally it is about, as I have told you, 8 to 10% will be there, 0.95. I am telling about 0.92 to 0.90 it will be there. So 8 to 10% means here he is telling that 0.95, no problem. So 5% he is taking now. So that will give you the area. When once you know the area and the area velocity of flow now, so this will give you the area into velocity of flow will give you the discharge now. You know the discharge. Already you know the discharge in the previous steps. In this step, the value of Q can be obtained because you know the power now. So because you know the value of Q and area, you can get the value of VF1 now. So VF1 is equal to KF into root 2 GH. That we know it now. So you can get the value of D from this equation now, because you know, because VF is equal to KF into root 2 GH, we can substitute in this expression the value of VF1, and you can get the value of D1 using the, because D1 is the only unknown. D1 is the only unknown. All other things are known to you, so you can obtain the value of this one now. So now the next one is U1 is equal to pi D1 into N now. So you can obtain the tangential velocity U1, and VW1 velocity of whirl at the inlet can be obtained by means of using, because this is nothing but what? This is nothing but work done divided by the this one. If you do the water horsepower, then you will get this expression VW1 U1 by GH. So this, using this expression, this expression is already being derived in the previous step. You just look into here. The same thing here we have derived already. VW1 U1 by GH. We have already derived this expression. Using this, you can obtain the value of, VW1. That is the next step now. So now the triangles can be obtained. You can get the value of alpha and theta, guide vane angle, as well as the absolute the angle with reference to the jet angle, or the angle the absolute velocity makes with the runner can be obtained, alpha and theta. These things can, runner vane angle and guide vane angle can be obtained. And assuming D2 is equal to D1 by 2, you can obtain the value of U2, as well as you can obtain the value of applying the continuity equation, you can obtain the value of the other factors, what is required, what is required. The velocity Vf2 can be obtained for the exit now. So with this, we have come to the numerical problems. Now, these are the things that we are taking. So this is how the things will be there, which I have shown you now. These are called the guide vanes, how the water will move to the guide vanes. So just once again, I got some more pictures of the Francis turbine. So how the flow will occur and how will, what will be the size of the this one now, Francis turbine inside. So that you should know it now. This is the runner, total runner, how it will be. So you should know the dimensions, because you should be proud that you just see here the man's height is about 6 feet, if you assume. So how much is the height? You just see here now. So it is about 25 feet. That means what? If the man's height is about 1.75 meter, so it is about 2 into 3, about 5.5 meters. That is the depth of this one. That you should magnanimously think why this picture is being given. What should be the, what is the dimension? You should not think that it is a very small plate like that. So this is only a picture here. So actually in the field, this will be the size of the runner now. So it will be about 5 to 6 meter what you are seeing. For that purpose, this picture is being kept to you now. Okay. So we shall go to the problem now. The following data are given to a Francis turbine. Net head is equal to 50 meter. Speed is equal to 600 rpm. Eta h is equal to 84%. Shaft horsepower is equal to 400 hp he has given. How to convert hp to watts, we will look into it now. Flow ratio is equal to 0.2. And breadth ratio is equal to b is equal to n by d, n is equal to b by d, that is what he has given, 0.1. The outer diameter is 2 times the inner diameter, that is d2 is equal to 2 times d1, that's what outer diameter he is telling now. So the thickness of the vanes is 5%, so that also you have to take into account for finding the discharge, the circumferential area of the runner. The velocity of flow is constant, Vf1. Vf is constant now at inlet and outlet. Vf1 is equal to Vf2. And discharge is radial at outlet, that is Vw1 is equal to 0, or Vw2 is equal to 0, or Vw output, out is equal to 0. That's what we are saying now. You have to find the guide blade angle, that means you have to solve the velocity triangle. Runner vane angle is required, diameter of the runner at outlet, and the width is required. Width of the wheel at inlet is required now. So these are the data that is given now. As I've already told you, it is 1 HP is equal to 735.75 watts. 1 HP is equal to 735.75 kilowatts. So you will get watts, 735.75 watts divided by 1000. I have done, that is good. That will be 294.3 kilowatts now. Okay, Kf is known to you, and n is given, d1 is equal to 2 times d2. So this is because he has told you Vw2 is equal to 0, that the velocity at the exit is equal to 0. This is the radial output. This is the radial output. We want alpha, theta and phi. This will be the velocity triangle now. Okay. So we know that eta naught is equal to SHP divided by WHP, or water power, the shaft power divided by water power. P is equal to, it is already calculated, it is given now, 294.3 kilowatt is given now. So multiplied by 1000, you will get that is the power in watts you will get now. So you can get the value of Q now. Okay. So that Q is obtained. Vf1 is equal to Kf into root 2 Gh. Kf is given to you. Just look into here now. Kf is equal to 0.2. What is this 0.2? Here flow ratio. Kf is equal to 0.2 is given now. So that is being utilized, and we obtain the value of Vf1. Vf1 is equal to Vf2. That's also being given to you. Since the thickness is 5%, Kt is equal to 0.95. So the area is equal to KT into pi d1 b1 now, 0.95 into b1, and Q is equal to A into V. Vf is equal to 6.264 he has given now. So you can obtain the Vf1 is given 6.264.94, Q is equal to 0.714, that is being given to you now. So 0.95 d1, 0.1 d1, b1 by d1 is equal to 0.1 he has given now. You can get the value of d1 because Vf1 is equal to, what is Vf1? It is nothing but 6.264. This you can substitute here now and you can obtain the value of d1 now. D1 is the only unknown now. Okay, so when once d1 is obtained, b1 can be obtained now. So d2 is equal to d1 by 2 because it is given in the problem that is the outer diameter is 2 times the inner diameter. Outer diameter is 2 times the inner diameter is given now. So substitute that one, you will get the value of d2 is equal to d1 by 2, that you will get it now. So u1 is equal to pi d1 n by 60, this equation you will note to you. D1 is equal to 61.8 is being found, that is 0.618, n is equal to 600, it is already being given to you. So you can get the value of u1, the peripheral velocity u1 now. So the efficiency, hydraulic efficiency, use the formula. What is hydraulic efficiency? Work done by the shaft power, work done divided by, or power developed by the runner divided by the WHP. So VW2 is equal to 0 because it is being given as radial in this problem. The flow is radial means VW2 is equal to 0. That's what it is given now. In the problem he has given, you just see here, we should very seriously read this here now. The velocity of flow is constant at inlet and also at outlet. The discharge is radial at outlet. The discharge is radial at outlet. Immediately you should write VW2 is equal to 0. That is what you have to write it here now. So VW2 is equal to 0. Therefore, this equation will become WQ by G into VW1 into VW1 U1 now. So you will get VW1 U1 by GS. This formula is necessary to be remembered. That will be better to remember now whenever it is radial, because WQ and WQ will get cancelled. You will get GH will be there in the bottom. VW1 U1 by GH will be there now. You can get the value of VW1. So how we will get eta H into GH? Eta H into GH divided by U1, because U1 is already being obtained. U1 is equal to pi D1 N by 60. So you can get the value of VW1. That is the velocity of whirl at inlet. Okay. So that's how you can obtain now. So guide blade angle alpha. How do you find guide blade angle? Just see it now. This is the guide blade angle. How to obtain? Consider this triangle now. If you consider this triangle, what is that you will get now? So, this is the triangle that you want to consider now. 1 minute. This triangle you consider. You will get the expression tan alpha is equal to Vf1 divided by Vw1. You know Vf1 and Vw1, you can get the value of alpha. And if you want the runner vane angle, tan theta is equal to, what you will get now? What is tan theta? tan theta is equal to Vf1 divided by Vw1 minus of U1. Okay. So these two equations should be known to you now. So that's what we have taken. Vf1 divided by Vw1. Vf1 is equal to 6.264. You have already calculated in the first step only, 6.264. Here you have calculated 6.264. So Vw1, 22.73. Just now you have calculated 22.73. So you will get the value of alpha. And also runner vane angle, Vf divided by Vw1 minus U1, you will get the value of this one, get the value of alpha and theta. So diameter of the runner at inlet and outlet, U2 is equal to pi d2 n by 60. You know the value of d2. You already d2 is equal to d1 by 2. You have already calculated here 309. So that is being obtained. Using that, you can get the value of U2. Immediately there only you would have obtained. There is no waiting now. Okay. Tan phi. Now you go to this one now. Triangle this one. Because it is radial. What is tan phi from this triangle now? Tan phi is equal to Vf2 by U2. Opposite side by the adjacent side. Okay. Vf2 by U2 or V2 by U2. Anything. Vf2 by U2. So you can get the angle tan phi. The value of phi can be obtained. So there the problem ends now. Now we shall go to the second problem now. A Francis turbine works under a head of 120 meter. That is H is equal to 120 meter now. The diameter and width, that is D1 and B1, is 2 meter and 0.16 meter. The inner diameter and width is 1.2 meter and 0.27 meter, inner diameter. The flow velocity Vf1 is 8.1 meter per second. The velocity of the wheel at exit is 0, that is Vw2 is equal to 0. The outlet blade angle, outlet blade angle is 16 degree, that is phi is equal to 16 degree. Eta h is equal to 90%. Determine the power, speed, blade angle at inlet, blade angle at inlet alpha, and guide angle at inlet, that is theta. These are the things that you want to obtain. Very simple problem now. Okay. So here, once again, the same triangle comes into picture. Okay. Mostly, I don't change the triangle unless you require to change because of some values, what is going to happen. This will be U2 anyhow. This will be U2 now. Okay. So now, in this, this will be theta. This will be alpha. This will be alpha. Just this one is, this is to be changed. This is alpha and this is theta now. This will be angle theta. This is the angle alpha now. The angle which with absolute velocity makes with the U1 is called as alpha now. Okay. So now the equation, you know it now. Q is equal to, okay. So Vf2 by Vf1. So get the value of Vf2 by means of using formula. Vf1 into D1 B1 is known to you and D2 B2 is known to you now. And Vf1 is equal to 8.1. That is given to you now. Vf1 is given to you now. So you can get the value of Vf2. The value of Vf2 is obtained now. Okay. When once Vf2 is obtained, you can get the value of phi. You can get the value of phi. What is phi? Tan phi is equal to Vf2 divided by U2. Vf2 divided by U2. You get the value of phi or you can get the value of U2 now. Phi is also being given to, I think, 16 degree. Is it being given to you now? Yes, it is given to you in this problem. Phi is equal to 16 degree. Therefore, you can get the value of, you can get the value of U2 now. When once U2 is obtained, you can get the value of N now. U2 is equal to pi d2 N by 60. Okay, So D2 is known to you, n can be obtained now. When once n is obtained, you can get the value of u1 is equal to pi d1 n by 60. D1 is already being given, we've already utilized in the first step only, that is 2 meter. So that 2 meter is known to you and n is known to you, you can get the value of u1 now. Okay, so when once u1 is known to you, you can get the value of vw1 using the value of eta h. This equation is known, should be known to you, as I've already told you, vw1 u1 by gh is equal to eta h, that we know it already in the last problem we have used, and we have got the value of vw1 because eta h is equal to 91%, that is given to you, 90% is given to you in the problem. Here it is being given to you in the problem, you can get the value of vw1, that is the velocity of the whirl at the inlet, velocity of the whirl at the inlet. So that means in this triangle I have known this. If you want to solve this one, I require this one u1, vw1 and vf1 is known to you now. vw1 is obtained now, u1 is obtained now. we shall go ahead for finding the alpha now. Alpha is equal to vf1 by tan alpha is equal to vf1 by vw1. We have already obtained the value of vf1 is 8.1, that is given to you now. vf1 is known to you now. Okay, and you obtained the vw1 now, so therefore you can get the value of alpha now. Similarly, you can get the value of theta because you know everything in this one now. Theta is equal to vw1 minus of u1. vw1 minus of u1, that will give you the value of theta now. So that is nothing but tan theta is equal to vf1 divided by vw1 minus of u1, that will give you the theta value. Okay, so using that value I can get the value of theta now. So you can get the flow rate q, that is kt into pi db into vf. This is the equation, general equation. This kt is not given to you now, it is not given to you. Let us assume it as 100, that means there is no loss due to thickness. Then pi db into vf will give you the flow into the turbine now. Power is equal to what? How do you find power? Eta naught is equal to P, shaft torque power, divided by WQH, that we know it now. Therefore, WQH, that is what we know it now. So, eta naught into WQH will give you the power now. Okay. So, this is the extra thing that is being not asked. You can find it. You can find, this is called the specific speed. So, specific speed is 103 for this. Ns is equal to n root p divided by h to the power of 5 by 4. Okay. So, anyhow, this is not being asked. Anyhow, it is there, no problem now. May be asked now. So, this is how the problem is to be solved now. Now, the problems are simple, provided if you can write the velocity triangle, as well as if you understand, if you remember the formulas, it is easy to solve any problem now. So, internal and external diameter of the turbine, that is D1 and D2 he has given. D1 and D2 is this value, 0.6 and 1.2 now. Velocity of flow is constant, that is Vf1 is equal to Vf2. And head is 22 meter, h is equal to 22 meter is given now. And guide blade angle means it is the limit alpha. Alpha is equal to 10 degree is given. Velocity of vanes are radial at inlet, that is nothing but even at the inlet it is radial, exit it is radius. Just look into here, the figure will be like this now. Inlet also it is radial, u1 will be equal to vw1 in this case, u2 will be equal to vw2 in this case. Okay, vw2 will be equal to 0 now. Okay, that should be known to you now. So this is both radial, that is inlet and outlet radial. This velocity triangle. Very important. Okay. So VW1 will be equal to U1, U2, VW2 will be equal to 0. Velocity of wheel will be equal to 0. That is what he has given now. Find the speed. You want to find the speed of the runner vane angle. Runner vane angle means theta is obtained now. Theta is required at outlet. Runner vane angle at outlet is required now. Outlet means it is nothing but theta and phi. Okay. Hydraulic efficiency eta h is required now. Okay. So these are the data. D1 is equal to 1.2, D2 is equal to 0.6. VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 2.5, Head is equal to 22 meter, VW1 is equal to U1, that's what I told now. Theta is equal to 90 degree, radial inlet, VW1 is equal to U1, VW2 is equal to 0, V2 is equal to VF2 is equal to 2.5 meter per second. That is what? That is V2 now. Okay. Now, so just solve the problem, then it is this one. Tan alpha is equal to Vf1 by Vw1 or Vf1 by U1. Just see this inlet triangle, then it will be used. Tan alpha is equal to Vf1 by Vw1 or Vf1 by U1. So you can get the value of U1. When once U1 is obtained, U1 is equal to pi d1 n by 60, you can get the value of n now. Okay. This is very important to understand is here Vw1 is equal to U1. That is very important to be understood when it is radial. How the velocity triangle is to be written, just look into it here now. 1 second. U1 will be equal to Vw1. So tan alpha is equal to Vf1 by Vw1. Or it is equal to Vf1 by U1. That is important. Okay, that is important. From this, I have obtained the value of pi dn by 60. From this, I obtained the value of n. Okay. So, you got the value of n. And from that, you can obtain the value of u2. u2 is equal to pi d2 n by 60. d2 is known to you. He has given you the d1 and d2 is being given to you. D2 is equal to 0.6. d2 is equal to 0.6 now. So, d2 is given to you. You can get the value of u2 now. So, tan phi. Very simple problem. Tan phi is equal to what is this? V2 divided by U2 or Vf2 by U2. Tan phi is equal to V2 divided by U2 or Vf2 divided by U2. Anything. Vf2 by U2. So, you know Vf1 is equal to Vf1. The velocity of flow is constant now. What is being given now? Vf1 is equal to Vf2 is 2.5. That's what it is being given now. Velocity of flow is constant 2.5 meter per second. He has given now Vf1 is equal to Vf2. Using this, I obtained the value of phi. Phi is equal to 19.43 degree now. Eta H, this formula is to be derived already now. Vw1 U1 by Gh. You know everything now. Vw1 and U1 are one and the same. As you can see here now, Vw1 and U1 both are same now. So, no confusion. So, U1 you have obtained, that itself is equal to Vw1. That is the importance of this problem. Vw1, U1 divided by GH. H is 22, you can get the efficiency. Okay, very simple. Little confusion will happen because Vw1 is obtained. What is the value of U1? Like that, there should not be confusion. The Vw1 is equal to U1. That should be known to you. Okay. Vw2 is equal to 0. This is to be understood in this problem now. Okay. Vf2 is equal to V2. This is to be understood now. Okay. So, these concept if you develop, I think you can solve the problem without much difficulty. Okay. So, here design a Francis turbine runner with the following data. Net head is equal to 68 meter, N is equal to 750 meter RPM, P is equal to 330 kilowatts, eta h, eta naught, flow ratio, that is nothing but he has given you the value of kf, breadth ratio, this is nothing but n, diameter of the inner diameter is of the runner is half the outer diameter, that is t2 is equal to t1 by 2, that's what he has given. Assume 6% circumferential area of the runner, that is nothing but kt is equal to 0.94. 6% is circumferential area of the runner. So circumferential area of the runner to be occupied by the thickness of the veins. Now velocity of flow remains constant throughout the flow, that is vf1 is equal to vf2, and flow is radial at exit, that is nothing but vw2 is equal to 0. So when you read this problem, you should be in a position to write all these things though. Okay, when once p and eta h is given, what is the thing that you can obtain? So immediately you should write eta naught is equal to p divided by wqh. I know p, I know eta naught, I know the value of h. So what you can obtain? You can get the value of q. So that, like that, you should be in a position to solve the problem stepwise with a very quick analysis of the problem now. Okay, so here I have written here eta naught is equal to p over 2 wqh. As I told you, p over wqh is obtained now. When once kf is given, it is nothing but you have to get what is the value of kf, 0.15. That is the flow f. That's what, when once kf is given, it is understood that you have to calculate vf. You should immediately understood that you should use this formula, pi d1 b1 into vf is equal to q. This formula is to be utilized. That should be known to you now. Okay, so here in the first step I got the value of q. For the second step I will get the value of vf. Just look into here now, right? He has obtained the value of vf is equal to this one now, because you have already 2gh, that is kf into 2gh, you got the value of vf now. So using this vf, you have obtained the value of d now. You have obtained the value of d now. This is d1, that is d means inner diameter is obtained. When once, because you know the value of 0.1. What is 0.1? What is 0.1 here now? This 0.1 is being given as p1 by d1. This is what he has given. N is equal to b by d. That is being given now. You have to utilize that equation immediately. It should come into picture now. So you will get the value of inner diameter. The outer diameter can be obtained by means of the breadth is obtained now. Using the diameter, you can obtain the value of runner diameter, runner velocity. U is equal to pi dn by 60. So when once this is obtained, you can obtain the value of eta h. Okay. So the steps are to be followed properly now. So you can draw the triangle once again now. What is here now? So this is 90 degree because it is radial. Radial outlet means VW2 is equal to 0. This is what I told you. VW2 is equal to 0. This is the equation. So how do you obtain now tan alpha? If you want inner side, tan alpha is equal to VF by VW. Tan alpha is equal to VF by VW. This is guide bed angle, or tan theta, that is the runner angle, is equal to VF by U minus of VW. And here if you want outlet, tan phi is equal to VF1 by U1. Okay. So these three equations are known to you. Obtain one is guide blade angle, one is runner blade angle, guide blade angle at the outlet. Okay, that runner blade angle at the outlet can be obtained directly. So Vf by Vw, you can get the value of this one. Now tan theta, the same thing. So here tan phi, he has obtained this one now. Okay, because u1 is not known to you, you can get the value of u1 is equal to pi d1 n by 60. You know the value of d1 already. The relationship between d1 and the d2 is being given. That is 300. That is d1 is equal to d by 2, 300. So you can get the value of d1 and the corresponding u1 you can obtain now. And once u1 is obtained, you can use this equation. Okay, simple. So a derivation type of problem was being given once in your examination very long back. An inward flow reaction turbine. This inward flow is nothing but the Francis turbine, because the flow is from the out towards the center. It is called as inward flow reaction turbine. Now, radially, the velocity of flow is constant. That is, velocity of flow is constant means Vf1 is equal to Vf2 is constant and is equal to the velocity of discharge of the turbine. Show that the hydraulic efficiency is this one. That's what, where alpha and theta refers to guide vane angle and wheel vane angle. Wheel vane angle means runner vane angle. Okay, alpha is guide blade angle, wheel vane angle means runner angle, runner vane angle. Now, so simple, this is the equation, because once again the same thing will come into picture now in this problem, because same velocity triangle Vw2 is 0. That's what he has given now. Now, so here Vf is equal to Vw tan alpha, that we know it now. Vf is equal to Vw tan alpha. Okay, this is the equation number one. Just it will be utilized now. Tan theta is equal to, we are already using Vf divided by Vw minus Fu. So, or U is equal to Vw minus F Vf by tan theta. Just you transfer this equation, you will get the equation. That is Vw minus U is equal to Vf by tan theta. You will get, or U is equal to Vw minus of Vf by tan theta. This is written here now. So U is equal to Vw minus of Vf by tan theta. What is Vf? Vf is equal to Vw tan alpha divided by tan theta. From this is equation 1. From this equation 1. So I will take out Vw from this expression. You will get 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta. This is being called as equation 2 now. For radial exit, Vw1 is equal to 0. That is nothing but this. I am calling it as Vw1 outside now. So that is nothing but exit is Vw1 is equal to 0 now. So V1 is equal to Vf1 now. V1 will be equal to Vf1 now. Okay. So you will get head supplied to the turbine. What is the head supplied to the turbine? Is equal to work done or head utilized by the runner. What is the head supplied to the turbine? How much I have supplied? Work done. How much of work done by the turbine? Okay. Kinetic head at the exit. This is the loss. What is it? Is not being utilized. So the loss is nothing but V1 squared by 2G. This amount of loss is going to happen now. So that is nothing but V1. This is called as V1 now. V1 squared by 2G. This is V1 exit. So V1 squared by 2G is the loss that is going to happen. What is the work done by the runner for the rotation? That is nothing but Vwu by G. Vwu by G is called as the work done. What is work done? Work done is equal to Vwu by GH is called as the work done. So therefore, Vwu by G plus of V1 squared by 2G will give you the head on the turbine. What is this? Is the head at this point, not at this point. This is at this point. What is the head? That is nothing but VWU by G plus of, that is the work done by the runner, plus of kinetic energy at the exit, at this point. The one that is coming out here is V1. So V1 squared by 2G. That will give you the total head to the turbine now. Okay. From this expression, I brought VWU by G is equal to H minus of V1 squared by 2G. H is equal to VWU by G plus V1 squared by 2G. What I have written here, the same thing is being given to you now. So, here, VWU by G plus of V1 is equal to VF1. That's what we have written now. V1 is equal to VF1. I am substituting this equation now. VWU by G plus VF1 square by 2G, or VF1 is equal to VF, since the velocity of flow is constant, VWU by G plus VF2 square by G. This is what we are getting at the exit and at the inlet now. Substituting from this equation now, from the equation 1, what is this? VF is equal to VW tan alpha. I am substituting this equation now. So, VF square, what I am getting? VF square is there now. VF square is there. Therefore, what you will get? This expression, VW tan square, VW square tan square alpha. I will get VWU by G as it is, what is there in the first. First is VWU by G. This is being given as VW square tan square alpha by 2G. That's what you will get now. So VW by G is being taken outside now. VW by G is being taken outside. This is being taken outside then. Then what you will get now? You will get VW into 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta. VW into 1 minus of tan alpha. What is this one? 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta. Just look into here now. This is U. From equation 2 now. This equation 2 says that U is equal to, I will rub it off, then it will be clear to you now. Equation 2 states that U is equal to VW into this one now. VW into 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta. That is being written here now. VWU. What is U? VW by G into U is there now. I have taken it VW by G outside. U is equal to VW. This is equation 2. VW into 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta. This is being kept like that only. VW square tan squared alpha by 2G. That I will keep it outside now. So I can take now VW square by G outside now. This VW also I will take it outside now. VW square by G, if I take it outside, 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta, and this VW square tan square alpha by 2G, that will be there now. VW square by G, if I take it outside now, I will get 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta into tan square alpha by 2G, which is the next step that I will get now. So this is nothing but H. This is nothing but H now. So you substitute in the equation of the hydraulic efficiency. What is hydraulic efficiency? VWU by GH. That you know it now. What is U? You go to the equation number 2. I have written here now. Equation number 2, I have written here now. What is equation number 2? Just now I showed. Equation number 2 is U is equal to VW into 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta. I substituted that. This U, what is there here now? That I substituted here now. That VW into 1 minus tan alpha by G. The value of H is substituted from this expression. That is 3 if you call. This is 3. G, H is equal to VW square by G. into 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta, tan square by 2g. So now what are the things that will get cancelled? Vw square will get cancelled, gg will get cancelled. You will get with 1 minus tan alpha by tan theta in the numerator, 1 minus tan alpha by tan theta into tan square alpha in the denominator. So finally, if you simplify that, what you will get now? What you will get? This is the expression that you will get. 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta, 1 divided by 1 plus half tan square alpha divided by 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta. I have divided numerator and denominator by 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta. What will happen now? If I divide this, it will get cancelled, 1 in the numerator. If I divide here, 1 minus of tan alpha by tan theta, you will get half tan square, 1 plus half tan square alpha divided by 1 minus of tan alpha tan theta. That's what you will get. Okay. So, it is a simple, only it is having a trigonometry, not much this one now, no much of designs are there now. You should be in a position to solve by means of understanding the velocity triangle. Now, once again, we shall back to the problem now. The velocity of wheel at inlet of to the runner of an inward flow reaction turbine is 3.15 root h meter per second. What is h here? Net head. I think he will give you somewhere where h is the head in meters. He has given you, and the velocity at the inlet is 1.05 root h. The velocity of wheel at exit, that is Vw2. This is the velocity of flow at inlet, that is Vf1. And here what is this now? Velocity of wheel at the inlet, that is Vw1, 3.15. Okay. Velocity of flow at exit, that is Vf2, is equal to 0.83 root h, where h is the inner diameter of the runner is 0.6 times the outer diameter, that is d1 and d2 he has given now, the ratio. Assuming hydraulic efficiency as eta h is equal to 80%, compute the angles of the runner vanes, that is alpha, theta, phi and beta he has asked. Compute the angles of the runner vanes at inlet and exit. What he asked you is runner vanes means theta and phi is to be obtained. Theta and phi is to be obtained. That's what he has asked you now. Okay. The angles required is runner vanes at inlet and exit now. So here it is beta is obtuse. How beta is obtuse? Let us see it now. When the beta is obtuse, this will be the triangle that you will get. Okay. Here it will become u minus of Vw1 will come into picture if you want to find the value of phi. Tan phi is equal to Vf2 divided by tan phi is equal to Vf2 divided by u minus of Vw1 you will get. Of course, Vw1, I have taken it outlet, I have taken a Vw1. Here it is, it should be Vw. Let's look at it. You just draw the triangle, then it will move to you. So I have taken Vw and Vf here now. So just look into here now. So eta h is equal to eta Vwu minus of Vw1 u1 divided by gh, because he has not given velocity of release, exit is 0 now. And u by d is equal to u1 by d1 is equal to, because u1 is equal to pi d1 n or u inlet, pi d1 n by 60, u2 is equal to pi d2 n by 60. What you will get now? U1 by U2 U1 by U2 only. U1 by U2 is equal to D1 by D2 you will get. Okay, because pi are constant. These things will get cancelled. U1 by U2 is equal to D1 by D2 you will get now. Or this is, I have taken U and D are the inlet and U1 and D1 are the outlet. The same thing you will get it a picture now. Okay. So U1 is equal to D1 into U by D. So D1 is equal to 0.6. The ratio of outlet to inlet is 0.6 he has given. This expression is going to know. So VW1, he has given 3.1 root h. Just to look into it here. Velocity of well at the inlet is 3.15. That is the inlet VW1, and the corresponding U. Outlet is 0.22. He has given now 0.22 outlet into D1 outlet. This one is 0.6 U. So that is VW2 U2. U2 is equal to 0.62. This is VW1 outlet. I have taken it as U1 now. So that will be equal to 0.6 U now. So you will get GH. So you will get the value of U as 2.60 root H now. Okay. Now you go to the inlet triangle now. What is tan theta now from this expression? Now? What is tan theta? Tan theta is equal to VF divided by VW minus FU. Okay, that is the expression that we will get now. Just look at it here, VF divided by VW minus U. What is anything he has given in the problem? Just look at it. Velocity of flow, this is VF is given now. Velocity of whirl at the inlet, VW is given. And you have calculated the U. Okay. So, VF is given to you, VW is 2.60, U is known to you, VW is 3.15 root H. Just look into here, 3.15 root H, that is the inlet now. Okay. So, you can obtain the value of theta. Simple. Because root is given, root H is given, you should not worry about it. You should go on solving the problem. So, now, U1 is equal to D1 into U by D. This is what we have already 0.6 U. U1 is equal to 0.6 U you have taken now. Just you have already calculated 2.60 H now. Substitute, you will get outlet velocity is equal to 1.56 U. Outlet 1.56 root H. 1.56 root H you will get now. 0.6 into 2.60 because 2.60 root H now. So from this equation, what you will get now? From this expression, U1 that is the exit velocity is equal to 0.6 times U. That is 0.6 times 2.60 root H. Right, this is what we have obtained from this equation. So you can get the value of U1 now. So that is nothing but I have got 1.56 now. So 1.56 root H. What is this? This is nothing but the outlet runner velocity. What is VW? Just look into here now. What is VW1? VW1 is 0.22. U1 is greater than VW1. Therefore, the triangle is like this now. Beta is obtuse. Very important. When U1 is greater than VW1, this I am telling you right from the beginning. We have solved many problems in the previous classes, under that condition beta will become obtuse now. When beta becomes obtuse, the equation is 1.56 Vw minus of tan phi is equal to, what is the expression now? This is 1.56 and this is 0.22, Vw is 0.22. Just look into your 0.22 root h is there. Point, of course, root h is constant in both the cases. So you want tan phi from this equation. Tan phi is equal to u minus of Vw1. That is nothing but, you know everything, Vf2 divided by, Vf2 is computed, Vf1 is equal, Vf is equal to 1.505 root h, that is computed, Vf1 is equal to 0.83 root h, that is computed, it is given, just look into here now, velocity of flow at exit is given, 0.83 root h is given, divided by, the expression 1.56 root h minus 0.22 h. That will give you the angle of phi. So simple, you should be able to solve it. Don't be panicked that the values are given in the form of root h. Okay. So an inward flow reaction turbine, once again it is a Francis turbine, running at 400 rpm. The value of n is equal to 400. Requiring a discharge of 15 meter cube per second. Q is equal to 15 meter cube per second. Has overall efficiency of 90%. The velocity at the inlet of spiral casing. The velocity at the inlet of spiral casing is 8.5 meter per second. The pressure head is 230 meter. Pressure head is 230 meter. The center line of the spiral casing is 2.5 meter above the tail rest level. So here I have to consider the figure of the reservoir along with the tail rest, what we have discussed now. The diameter of the runner is 2 meter at inlet and width is, this is D1 is equal to 2 meter and width is equal to 0.25 meter. The hydraulic efficiency is beta h is equal to 94%. The flow is radial at outlet. That means Vw2 is equal to 0. What is the power developed by the turbine? What is P? Okay. What is specific speed? Ns is equal to what? What is guide vane angle? Alpha is equal to what? What is the runner blade angle? Theta is equal to what? And percentage of net head, which is kinetic at entry to the runner, the percentage of net head, which is kinetic at the entry of the runner. So this we will look at it. We will look at it. Assume the thickness of the plates are the maximum. That is, the KT factor will not come into picture now. So these are the things that he has given. N is equal to 400 rpm. Q is equal to 15 meter cube per second, overall efficiency eta h, and velocity of inlet spiral casing is 8.5, pressure head D1 and V1. So this is the triangle we have assumed now, general triangle now. So I have already told you the head supplied to the runner is nothing but work done by the runner plus kinetic head at the exit. This is what we discussed in the previous this one. I think I have not copied on the figure. We will look at it here now. We have already drawn the figure in the previous problem. In the previous problem, we have drawn the problem. This is the thing now. So this is the kinetic energy at the exit now. How much kinetic energy at the exit? What is the work done? This is to be taken into, this figure is to be taken into account now. Okay. So now, head at the inlet of the spiral casing, work done or head utilized by the runner plus kinetic head at the exit. So what is the head supplied to the runner? If this is the turbine that is there now. This is the turbine that is there now. Now what is the head supplied to the runner? Is equal to what is the work done by the runner? Plus what is the kinetic energy that is not being utilized? That is V1 squared by 2G. That is not being utilized by us now. Plus this head is to be taken. This is the extra head that is to be taken now. So work done at the head, work done or head utilized at the runner, that is nothing but 230 that is being given to you. That is the pressure head at the runner. That is nothing but at the beginning of the spiral casing, that is 230. Okay, plus 8.5 square by 2g. What is 8.5? That is V1. That's what it is given to you. 8 point velocity of inlet at the spiral casing. That is what it is given to you. V1 squared by 2g. Okay, spiral casing. This is what we have supplied here. This is what we have supplied. V1 squared by 2g plus of this one plus 2.5 meter above the spiral casing. It is there now. What is this 2.5 meter? So here he has given you the center line of the spiral casing is 2.5 meter above the tail race. So that is to be taken into account. That will give you the total pressure at this point. So if you draw the manometric equation with reference to the tail race, so the work done by the runner or head utilized by the runner plus V1 square, what is there in the beginning? That is V1 square by 2G. Okay, that will give you the total head supplied to the turbine now. So what is overall efficiency now? Overall efficiency is equal to power divided by WQH, that we know it now. SHP divided by WQH now. So therefore power developed is equal to this. WQH 236.2, H will come into picture. WQ is now, Q is given to you, 15 meter cube per second is given now. Therefore, you will get the value of the power developed by the turbine. How you know it now? Is there any problem now? So just look into it once again, I will tell you. There should not be any problem in calculating this one now. So it is the turbine that we are having now. The turbine is there here now. And this is the draft tube that is there now. And draft tube is 2.5 meter above. This is the center of the runner. Here the velocity with which it is sending is 2.5 meter per second. This is the kinetic energy supplied. Plus the pressure head at this point is being given it as 230 meter. Pressure head that is at this point is 230 meter. That is what it is given now. Pressure head is 230 meter. It is given now. Pressure at this point, the velocity at the inlet spiral casing is 8.5 meter per second, 8.5 meter per second, and the pressure at this point, that is at the inlet is 230 meter. That means here, this is what being connected to the penstock. This is the penstock now. From the penstock, it is entering into the runner now. So let us not think, this is the spiral casing. So the water is entering into the runner now. So now, here at this point, the pressure head is 230 meter, the kinetic energy is so much. Therefore, the total head is equal to this plus 2.5 meter above the tail rest. At this point, what is the total head? This is jet with reference to tail rest. This is jet. This is V squared by 2G. This is P by W. Pressure head is equal to P by W. So you know everything, you got the head now. That is the input. This is the input head. 236.2. So you can get the value of the power developed by the runner. Okay. Specific speed, Ns is equal to n root p divided by h to the power 5 by 4. That you know it now. Okay. P is equal to, you calculated in the previous step, 31,281. Very important thing that you want to understand here is, in the specific speed, this should be always in kilowatt. Okay, not in watts. That should be understood to you now. Okay. And discharge is equal to pi dB into Vf. So you know the discharge Q. So you can get the value of Vf1 now. When once Vf1 is obtained, the peripheral velocity U1 is equal to pi D1 n by 60. No problem. This also being given to you. Value of D1 is being given to you in the problem. D1 is equal to 2 meter. That is being given to you. And D2 can also, is also being given to you. No problem now. VW2 is equal to 0 because it is radial now. Eta H is equal to VW1 U1 by GH. So you can get the value of VW1. And tan alpha is equal to Vf1 by Vw1. This expression now. Tan alpha is equal to Vf1 by Vw1. You can obtain it. No problem. Given to you now. Tan theta is equal to Vf1 divided by Vw1 minus of u. So everything is known to you. Just substitute it now. Kinetic head as percentage. Kinetic head as percentage of net heads. That's what we want now. So for that purpose, you have to calculate the value of V1. The absolute velocity is to be obtained. This absolute velocity is to be obtained now. What is the value of absolute velocity? So just obtain, because you know VW, you know the value of alpha, you can get the value of V1 now. V1 is equal to 52.87. So this is the kinetic head. This is the kinetic head at the entrance, V1 square by 2G. This is the total head. Total head is equal to root H. H, H is equal to 236.2. V1 square, V1 is equal to 52.7. That is 60.3%. Percentage of head, which is kinetic at the entrance. That means how much of velocity energy is there. The velocity energy is equal to 60.3 at the entry. The velocity energy is equal to 60.3%. Remaining only about 40% is the pressure energy. As I told you in the Francis turbine, the flow will be both kinetic and pressure. Both energy will be there now. In the impulse turbine, completely as it enters, completely that will be converted into kinetic energy, velocity energy. But in the Francis turbine, part of the energy will be form of the velocity energy and part will be kinetic energy. This pressure energy is to be converted into kinetic energy as it flows through the runner. So that means in this problem, about 40% of the pressure energy is to be converted into kinetic energy as it flows through the runner to the draft tube. That should be understood to you in this problem. That concept is to be known to you. Now a Francis turbine has an overall efficiency of 76%. Eta naught is equal to 76%. Now is required to produce 150 kilowatt. That is SHP is equal to 150 kilowatt. It is working under the head of 8 meter. It is working under the head of 8 meter. That is H is equal to 8 meter. The peripheral velocity is 0.25 times root 2 GH. Peripheral velocity means U1 is equal to 0.25 times root 2 GH. And the radial velocity at the inlet, that is VR, is equal to 0.95 root 2 GH. The wheel runs at 1 RPM, 150 RPM. N is equal to 150 RPM. And the hydraulic losses in the turbine is equal to 20%, that is loss is 20%. The available energy, available 20% of the available, assume radial discharge, that means VW2 is equal to 0. Find guide blade angle, alpha is equal to what? Wheel vane angle at inlet, that is theta is equal to what? Diameter of the wheel at inlet, that is D1 is equal to what? Width of the wheel at inlet, B1 is equal to what? That's what he has asked you. Simple problem. These are the things that are given now. U1 is equal to 0.25 times root 2 GH. Why 0.25? I have given you now. 0.25 times root 2 GH is given now. The value of H is already being given. That is 8 meter. That is also being given to you. Substitute and get the value of U1. VF1 can be obtained now. Hydraulic efficiency is equal to what? Shaft power, SHP, cured by water power. So 20% loss is there now. So if P is the power that is generated, minus of 20% of P is the loss. That is 0.8P divided by WP you have to write now. That's what? 0.8H divided by H. That will become 0.8 immediately. If total head is H, 20% is loss. 20% of the total head is lost, that's being 20% of the available energy is being lost. So you will get 0.2H divided by H. That is nothing but what we are calling Hg minus of Hf divided by H. HL we are calling it as. That is what we are calling it. Hg minus Hf is equal to HN only now. That is, what is Hg? That is here the 1 minus of 0.2 divided by 1. That will become 0.8 now. Okay. So you know that eta H is equal to VW1 U1 by GH. VW2 is 0 because it is radial output. So you get the value of VW1. U1 is already being found to you now. So you want to get the diameter of the inlet. That is equal to U1 is equal to pi D1 L by 60. You know it now. So get the value of D1 now. So how to find the width of the inlet, what we are having now? KT into pi dV into VF. That is to be used. That should be known to you now. Q is equal to KT into pi dV into VF. That should be used to you because he has asked you B. Pi D1, B1 is to be used. So for that, what you require? You require the value of Q. You require the value of Q. How do you find the Q? You know the P, the value, and WQH is known to you. You know the value of Q. You want to get the value of Q now because he has given you the efficiency as 76%. He has given you the efficiency as 76%. Overall efficiency is 76%. He has given to you now. Using this, you get the value of the Q. And that Q you utilize and get the value of B1. What is Q? Q is equal to KT into pi D1 into B1. But KT, there is no loss. There is no, what he has given you now? You assume there is no thickness loss here. We are assuming there is no thickness loss. That should be there. There is no thickness loss. Then Q is equal to pi dB VF is to be taken. Assuming that there is no loss due to thickness of the wave. Pi D1 into V1, that we have taken now. D1 is equal to 0.398, that is being obtained. B1 is to be calculated. VF is being calculated. You just do it. 11.9 into 11.9 you have already obtained. VF is equal to 11.9. This is being obtained. So just use it and get the value of B1. Okay, so there the problem ends now. So these are the data. Can you do it? You just look at it. Net head, speed, shaft power, overall efficiency 92%, hydraulic efficiency 92%, flow ratio 0.22, breadth ratio 0.11, outer diameter is 2 times the unit diameter, velocity of flow is constant. Outer discharge is radial, that is VW2 is 0. Velocity of flow is constant, that is VF1 is equal to VF2. okay, outer diameter is 2 times inner diameter, D1 is equal to 2 times D2. That's what we have given now. The thickness occupies 6%, so that is KT is equal to 0.94. That's what it is given. Diameter of the runner at inlet and outlet, that is D1 and D2 is he has asked you now. Width of the wheel at inlet, that is V1. And guide blade angle, you have to calculate alpha is equal to what? Runner vane angle, theta is equal to what? At inlet and outlet, phi is equal to what? These are the things. I think you can do this problem now. So here I have written 0.94, just look it together now. Flow ratio is equal to 0.22, Vf is equal to 0.22 into root 2 gh, 8.15. Okay. Flow ratio is 0.22 is given now. Okay. See 0.94. Vf2 is equal to V2 because Vw2 is equal to 0. Vf2 is equal to V2. Okay. As usual, short power divided by water power. Short power is 330. You get the value of Q. Regular procedure, no change. No change. So the relationship between B1 and D1 is given to you. Here, 0.1. 0.1 is given to you. In the problem now, just look into here now. Breadth ratio, L is equal to B1 by D1. It's equal to 0.1. That is given to you. So just substitute, get the value of D1 now. And the relationship between D1 and D2 is given to you. D2 is equal to 0.5 D1. The flow is radial, therefore Vw2 is equal to 0. Use this velocity triangle, get the value of alpha, theta and phi. Okay. Get the value of U1. U1 is equal to pi D1 n by 60. And get the value of Vw1 because eta h is known to you. H is equal to you, U1 is equal to you, get the value of Vw1. Alpha and theta, tan theta is equal to, just look into the problem now. Tan theta is equal to, we have already thought Vw minus of U. Tan theta is equal to this Vf1 divided by Vw minus of U. Right, and the same thing, phi, the value of phi is equal to tan phi. From this expression, from this triangle, you can get the value of tan phi is equal to Vf by U1. So you know, you can calculate the U1 beginning and you can get the value of tan phi also. A vertical shaft Francis turbine 420 rpm while discharge 15 meter cube per second. The velocity and the pressure head at the entrance is 10 meter per second and 230 meters respectively. The elevation above the tail race is 5 meter. The diameter of the runner is 2 meter and the width is D1 and B1 is given 279. The overall hydraulic efficiency is eta naught. Overall eta naught is 92% and the value of eta h is equal to 98% given to you. Calculate. what is this total head H across the turbine. We want to calculate head across the turbine, power output, the guide vane angle alpha, vane angle at inlet theta, density may be taken as rho is equal to 1000 meter cube per second. Not much risk now. Same thing what I told, total head across the turbine is equal to H plus V1 squared by 2G plus Z. So this H is given to you 230 meter. Here is given. The velocity and the pressure at the entrance of the runner. Velocity and pressure head. This is the velocity head 10 meter. Velocity only. The pressure head is 230 meter. Velocity is given 10 square. That is velocity square by 2g plus z. Tail race is 5 meter above. That's what it is given now. The tail race, the elevation of the tail race is 5 meter above the tail race. So that is to be taken. That will give you the total head now. So this is the total head H. Use this equation. Once again, regular, directly you can come to eta naught is equal to WQH. This is the kilowatt you will get eta naught now. Q is given in this problem. In the previous problems, eta naught is given. You can, Q is also being given. Therefore, you can get the total head. In the previous problem, we were calculating the value of Q, knowing the head now. In this case, eta naught and H is given, you can get the total power now. Once again, in this expression, beta is obtuse now. Let's look at it, how it is. So, U is equal to pi dN by 60, regular. Q is equal to pi dB into Vf. Kt is not given, it is absent, it is being taken now. So you will get the value of Vf1 now, because you have not told anything about Kt now. Okay, you know the value of Q now, you can get the value of Vf1. Sin alpha is equal to, you can get the value of alpha. Vf1 by V1. That's what the various this one. Okay, V1 is known to you, that is important here now. V1 is 10 meter per second. Okay, what is V1? Velocity, this is nothing but absolute velocity. Very important in this problem, this is absolute velocity. That means, you know in this problem, this. Okay. V1 is known to you now. Previously, we were obtaining the value of U. That is not there now. So, you have to obtain now. So, therefore, only we have used sin alpha. Sin alpha is equal to V of 1 by V1. We are not utilizing anything about U. You can obtain the value of U afterwards now. Okay. So, tan theta is equal to V of 1 divided by U1 minus of V alpha, V1 cos alpha. You know the value of U1, 43.98. You can obtain the value of theta now. Okay, you can obtain the value of theta now. Okay, now the velocity of, that's how you have to solve the problem, nothing more than that. It is not a very simple problem now. Okay, so here we have not calculated the velocity of whirl at all. The velocity of whirl is not being computed at all now. Okay, you can obtain the value of velocity of whirl and obtain also, but here we have not calculated the velocity of whirl now. That should be known to you now. Because the requirement is only, the requirement for this is only total head across the power output, guide vane angle at inlet, density of water is taken, only so much is asked. Therefore, we are not worried about more of calculation of the velocity triangle. In an inward flow reaction turbine, the sum of the pressure and kinetic energy at the entrance of the, very important, at the entrance of the spiral casing, sum of the pressure and kinetic energy. In an inward flow reaction turbine, the sum of pressure and kinetic head at the spiral casing is 132 meter. Okay, that is H plus V1 square by 2G. The vertical distance between this section and the tail rest, that is Z, is 3.3 meter. That is, total head is equal to 132 plus 3.3. That should be taken now. The peripheral velocity at the runner, that is U. U is equal to 33, U1 is equal to 33 meter per second. U1 is equal to peripheral velocity of the runner at entry now. The radial component of the velocity, velocity of flow, is constant, that is Vf1 is equal to 11 meter per second. And the discharge from runner is without well, that is Vw2 is equal to 0. The hydraulic losses are losses between the turbine entrance and the discharge from guide vanes is 4.95. Very important. This problem is very important. Losses in the runner is 8.8 meter. Losses in the draft tube is 0.88 meter. Kinetic energy rejected at the tail race is 0.55 meter. Determine the guide vane angle, runner vane angle, blade angle, and the pressure head at the entrance of the disc. So this problem will tell you about the various losses that is going to take place now. Okay, so now guide vane angle is to be calculated now. So the total head is 132 plus 3.3. What is 132? I have told you, this is the first I have written, 132 plus 3.3, that is kinetic energy plus this one, minus of the losses, minus of the hydraulic losses. What are the hydraulic losses that is being given now? So here he has given you loss in the turbine entrance, loss in the runner, loss in the draft tube, kinetic energy loss. So that is the head that is being wasted. So that has been given 4.95, 8.8, 0.88, 0.55. This is the head utilized by the runner now. This is the total energy supplied. Total energy supplied is the head, kinetic, total head, pressure head plus of kinetic energy. This is 132 plus 3.3. This is the losses that is going to happen, and totally you will be 120.12 now. But H is equal to what? That is the work done by the runner, that is Vw1 U1 by G. Okay. Therefore, you can get the value of Vw1 from this expression. So from inlet velocity triangle, directly this is the inlet velocity triangle, tan alpha is equal to Vf1 by Vw1. That very once again, the same procedure. Tan alpha is equal to Vf1 by Vw1. This is the value of alpha. Tan alpha is equal to Vf1 by Vw1. And tan theta is equal to Vf2 by Vw minus of U, Vw minus of U. That will get the tan theta. So theta is obtained now. Now, pressure head at the entry. How do you find the pressure head? This is the 132.33, the total pressure that is being this one now, is equal to V1 squared by 2G plus P1 by W plus Z1 plus 4.95. So, what is this 4.95? The 4.95 is the, just look into here now, very important step here. Losses between the turbine entrance and discharge from the guide vane. Losses from the turbine entrance and the discharge from the guide vane. That is 4.95 now. So that will give you this one now. So Z1 is equal to 3.3, that is the difference. This level and this level is 3.3 turbine runner, and this is being given to you 3.3. Okay. V1 is equal to VF1 by sin alpha, that is we have obtained from this expression, from this triangle we have obtained. V1 square by 2G you can obtain from that equation now. So 132 plus 3.3, P1 by W is equal to how much? What is P1 by W? 132 plus 3.3 minus V1 square by 2G minus Z1 minus 4.5. So that will give you the pressure head at the entry, because I told you here you will be having both pressure energy as well as the kinetic energy will be there now. In the previous case we call it as 60% here now. We have calculated as it is how much it is now here now. So this is the V1, that is the entry velocity is we have obtained from this velocity triangle, V1 square by 2G. And Z1 we have obtained. This is the, we have already got 132 plus, that is the pressure energy at the entry, plus of 3.3, this is the velocity. What is 3.3? What is 3.3? 3.3 is being vertical distance between this section and the tail race. That's what totally we have got is at 3.3 now. So total head, this is 132 up to what is given, 132 meter. What is this now? Pressure in the inward flow reaction turbine, the sum of the pressure and the kinetic energy. Pressure energy is 132 meter. So if you total head, if you are thinking now, this is up to here 132 meter plus of 3.3 meter up to the tail race. Total energy is that one. Total energy should be equal to what is the velocity energy that I am taking, what is the pressure energy that is going. This is the net energy, that is 132 plus 3.3 should consist of the velocity energy that I am putting onto the turbine, the pressure energy that I am putting onto the turbine, plus the losses that is going to take place here now, plus of this is not being utilized, 4.95. That is the total losses and Z1 now. This Z1 is nothing but this one now. So from that point of view, from this we have obtained, this is the equation. This is the equation what we have written for this now. Very important here is 132 meter is the pressure energy, that is the pressure head. It is the pressure head at this point. The pressure head at this point is 132 meter. Pressure head at this point is 132 meter now. From here to here is 132 meter. Here is given, that is the pressure head now. Okay. This is the pressure head I am telling. And this pressure head is also having the water that is discharging into it. That will be 132 plus 3.3. That is the total net pressure, total net head. Total net head is equal to 132 plus 3.3. Should comprise of this pressure energy, what is there now, plus of the velocity energy, what is there, plus of the distance between the center of the turbine to the tail race, that is 3.3, that is Z, datum energy, plus of the losses that is going to take place now. So that is what, that is 4.95 in total now. So Z is equal to 3.3. This 3.3 will get cancelled here now. Once again, that should be here. This will get cancelled now. So 132 plus 3.3 plus V1 squared by 2G plus 37.37, that is V1 is equal to VF1 square, VF1 by sin alpha. You will get the value of pressure energy what is entering into here. So like this we should solve the problem. I think we have solved many problems here now. You should be in a position to understand the, once again, the velocity triangle. I have applied the Bernoulli's equation between the turbine entrance and runner arm outlet. Turbine entrance and runner outlet. Runner outlet means what? It is the exit of the runner now. Turbine entrance and runner of the outlet. This is the exit of the runner. So what you will get? Total pressure I have given is 132 plus 3.3. That should be equal to V2 square. That is the velocity energy I am giving. The pressure energy I am supplying into it. The jet 2, once again 3.3 only. The same thing. And the value of H, 4.95 is the loss. 8.8 meter. What is 8.8 meter? 8.8 is given, I think. What is? Just look into here now. Losses in the runner. Losses in the runner, losses in the draft tube. So losses in the runner is given to you now. So that loss in the runner is being given to you now. So V2 is going to you now. H is known to you, 120.12. We have obtained. Okay. So substituting, we will get H is equal to 120.12. Okay. So from that, you get the value of P2 now. Okay. So P2 by W is equal to 8.04 meter. P1 by W is nothing but what? Pressure head at the entry. Pressure head at the exit, if you want, means. So first, in the first test, what you have found? We have found the pressure head at the entry. Entry means what? At the entrance of the runner. At the entrance of the runner, that is P1 by W. So at this point, that is P1 by W. At the exit, it will be equal to P2 by W. So for finding P1 by W, I use this equation. The same equation is being utilized by applying the Bernoulli's equation between this point and this point. Nothing more than that. So I have applied the total head is equal to V2 square by 2G. That means velocity at this point, V2 square by 2G. V2 square by 2G plus P2 by W plus Z2. Okay. Z2 is equal to 3.3 only. Once again it is. Plus H. Plus H. Okay. H is equal to 120.12. 120.12. 1 minute. Here you have obtained. Head utilized by the runner. That is 120.12. Okay, that is the total head, 120.12. So head utilized by the runner is 120.12 plus the jet energy, plus pressure energy, plus velocity energy, plus 4.95 plus 8.88. Okay, so you will get what is 4.95 is being given to you, losses in the turbine. 8.8 is the loss in the runner. Loss between the turbine entrance and the discharge from the guide vanes. Losses in the runner. Both these will happen in the runner only. Both are happening in the turbine only. This is nothing but turbine loss, we can say. The turbine loss is to be added for it. If you want to get the, this is nothing but these are the turbine loss. So total head what I have subtracted is 132 plus 3.3 should be equal to V2 square by 2G plus P2 by W plus Z2 plus of 120.12, that is the head at the entrance plus the losses. You will get the value of P2 by W now. So, maybe you will be understanding how the losses will occur, how the things will happen in the turbine, as well as in between the penstock here, we are calculating first P1 by W, Next, we calculated P2 by W. P1 by W only looks at the losses up to penstock, whereas P2 by W, when you are calculating, you have to 4.95. That is what 4.95 is nothing but what? We have calculated 4.95 loss between the turbine entrance, loss between the turbine entrance and discharge from the guide vanes. So that is at the entrance only we are taking now. We are not taking more than that now. So now from the turbine here, applying turbine entrance and the runner outlet. After passing through the guide vane, the water will flow towards the runner. So this will only take the runner loss, 4.95, and this one. Okay, this 4.95 will come under guide vane loss. This is guide vane loss. This is nothing but what? This is runner vane loss. And this is the 120.12 is the, we have already calculated exit, that is the head utilized by the runner. Head utilized by the runner is 120.12. This is head utilized by the runner. Runner. So these are regular over. V2 squared by 2G. P2 by W plus Z2, this is with reference to the runner. What is the velocity energy? What is the pressure energy? What is the datum energy? This is equal to 3.3. This is constant now. This will get out because this side we already added 3.3. This 3.3 will get cancelled. Okay. V2 squared by 2G plus P2 by W. This is the total energy what I have supplied to the turbine. Energy supplied to turbine. Energy supplied to turbine. Okay. Energy supplied to turbine plus head utilized minus of the losses should be equal to the what is the head we have supplied. Okay. So we can get the value of P2 by W from this now. So once again go through this problem and try to understand the thing. We shall stop at this stage. I think we have done lot of problem on Francis turbine. So please be ready to solve the problems anytime. You try to revise the problem and try to see that you are comfortable in the problem, solving the problems of Francis turbine. In the next class, we shall go to the second type of reaction turbine, that is Kaplan turbine. Thank you.